OER Info is live at OER 18, and our first guest today is Martin Weller. Martin Weller has so many titles, it wouldn't even fit in one tweet. Basically, he's Mr. OER Research. He's with the Open University, he's the president of ALT. What else is very important to...
Director of OER Hub at the OU, so yeah, so it's a lead on research, yeah.
And we're talking about your research. You have recent findings on sustainable business models. That's what everyone is looking for. And you found answers. And can you give us a short preview on what you find out?
Yeah, so it's some research that was funded by ICDE. And we really wanted to look at what the different models of what we're calling OOFAT, Open, Online, Flexible, and Technology-Enhanced Learning. And what we were really interested in was, what are people actually doing in that area? So how are they using online technologies? How are they using openness to kind of fulfill their mission as universities? And so we conducted a survey globally, and we had 69 different responses from different countries. And we really tried to map how people are using technology. And what we came up with were six OOFAT models. So for some people, we've got kind of things which are OOFAT at the core, so it's kind of like it's central to their entire mission. So people like the OER University, for instance, kind of openness pervades everything they do. And for other people, it's very much about, they might be doing it for a very specific purpose. It might be we're trying to target vocational learners, and for them they need to have flexible access, those kind of things. So it might be a very specific purpose. And so we mapped these kind of six different types and provide case studies of those. And we also looked at the business models, and that work we kind of tried to split it up into what are called defender approaches and prospector approaches. So defender approaches, they're using the technology and those approaches to kind of really enhance their current position and their current marketplace, whereas prospector strategies are kind of looking to build and find new audiences and new markets. And the whole pitch of that work really is not to say that one approach is right and one is wrong. It's trying to move away from that kind of narrative you get from Silicon Valley about that there's one answer, one kind of revolution, everyone needs to do this thing. Actually, it's a very nuanced, mixed picture. And we've provided at the end of that report, which is being launched next week at the OE Global conference officially, a kind of checklist, a kind of package for you to work through. So first of all, you look at where are we currently in those OOFAT models, which one, so we get the kind of set of questions, which one matches us the most, which one would we like to move to, and what would be the business strategy that would allow us to move to that. So it's trying to be a very kind of practical approach, but also very inclusive. So it covers, so not just online universities, not just distance education, but also campus universities, and not just people who want to be fully open, but people who might want to meet a very particular purpose, particular audience. So it's been really interesting, I think. And I think it's much more of that kind of structured approach and balanced approach rather than sort of saying there's one size fits all in terms of application of these technologies. So tune in next week for the launch, funded by ICDE, and there's a live webinar, I think it's Tuesday. Yeah, Tuesday afternoon. So...
thank you very much. For everyone out there, if you see this later than live, you can maybe already Google it. It's OOFAT, is OOFAT. I learned this today. It's OOFAT, OOFAT, Martin Weller. These are the words you should Google to find out more about OOFAT and the future of open education. Thank you, Martin.
Thank you.